You're the man of the hour. How you feel today, boss?
I feel good, but how you feel?
Very good. You know, Atlantic City show you a lot of love.
Yes, always. Always. And I showed them a lot of love.
You did everything, man.
I tried.
You fight, you actually commentary, your TV, you do everything, man.
I try to be a catalyst in the sport, try to get the sport all I have.
Give me a word of wisdom for today, boss.
Word of wisdom is it? Thank God for everything. Keep God first in everything you do, and you'll always be fine.
His career span from 1989 to 2018. Has held multiple world championships in 4 weight classes. From middleweight to super middleweight to light heavyweight, all the way to heavyweight. He made it also to the 1988 Olympics, the youngest member of the team at the time. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please put your hands together for Mr. Roy Jones Jr.
Some of those guys truly were angels. Tony Thornton was truly an angel. And God bless his son. I seen you. I didn't know that was you, man, but your dad was a hell of a man.
Vinny Pazienza was an angel. There were several times when I was getting to go deal with Mike Tyson the last time, I would wake up, knees hurting, ain't feeling good, and I would think about people like Vinny Pazienza come back from a broken neck and challenge me. He would just come back from a broken neck and fight. He came back and asked for the best dude fighting at the time. You understand me? After a broken neck, I was scared to fight him because he's so crazy. You feel me? And he don't care. So every time I have illnesses, I get up and think about people like Vinny. Or I think about people like John Scudder. You know, you meet angels sometime, and they may be an angel, but they seem like a devil at first. Because I sparred several rounds with John Scudder, and I would tell all y'all one thing. John Scudder ain't stopped chasing me yet. Now, I might have got the best of it, but that don't mean he stopped. He still be after me sometimes in my dream, because that's what John Scudder was. You understand me? So you meet people, and you never know what you're going to get out of them. But back to this referee. All this man had to tell me was stop, and I would have never laid another hand on that lady child, because I don't do stuff like that. Stop means stop where I'm from. You understand me? If that man says stop, Larry, you know the referee's supposed to say stop. He got three commands. Stop, break, and something else, step back and punch or something. Anyway, he ain't got three commands. One of them is stick box, that's something. Stop breaking box. I understand those three things. I don't understand Russian yet. I'm a Russian citizen, but I don't understand Russian yet. But I do understand stop, break, and box. If he says stop, I'm going to take my hands, back up, and let you do what you got to do to that man. But he didn't say that. So this man ain't for 5'6", so he a midget. I can't look down there and see his knee down. I don't know that. That ain't my job. That's the referee's job to tell me he down. If he say stop, that mean that man down. Don't hit him no more. You feel me? That ain't my job. I trained too long, too hard, 2 minutes sparring session to come here wondering is that man knee on the ground. That's the referee's job. That ain't my job. Oh yeah, y'all saw my hunt. Y'all saw how Barack Muhammad came up here and had y'all days with his talking today? He amazed us with his talking, right? He gave these ladies all the respect in the world, which they deserve, right? He did a beautiful job of talking. That's why I let him talk to HBO. They don't want to hear me what I got to say? I give y'all somebody better. He'll come in here and make it sound like I'm worth $100 million. Not three, not five. He'll make y'all think y'all be paying me 10, 12, because that's who Barack Muhammad is. He, like he said, he's a promoter. He promotes the product. You understand me? I was the product. He's the promoter. Sometimes you gotta let people do their job. You gotta construct a team and let your team members do what they're best at doing. You understand me? A lot of times I'm out of touch with things, but John Scudder called me and said, hey, I need this. I know when I see John Scudder's name on his phone, answer that call, because somebody in the boxing industry needs something. Now I don't know who it might be. It might be the Blade. It might be anybody. I don't care who it is. If they box up, they're within this fraternity, and I can do for them, and if it only takes something like a simple autograph that somebody can auction off, I'm going to do that because that's who I am. But back to this referee. So the man talked all that noise. We got 5 months between the fight. And this is another thing about me. I'm going to tell y'all like this. They told me after the fight, they said, what you want? What you want to do? I said, get him back up here. They said, he going to want all the money. I said, give it to him. He going to need it. I don't want no money, just tell him bring that little green strap you got. See, that's the difference where us that love boxing, we didn't fight for the money, we fought because we wanted to be the best. You understand me? Most of these people out here that I know, Ray Mercer's of the world, John Scudder's of the world, Al Cole's of the world, Blade Barker of the world, we fought because we wanted to be the best. We didn't care what the dollar sign said. I told him, I don't give up the lawyer. Tito knew about the lawyer, he was about to sign with the lawyer too. I told the lawyer, I could care less about how much money they paid me. Tell him, bring that little green thing that said WBC on it, and that's all I need to see that night. And that's all I need to see. Now, I went to the press conference, which I didn't want to go to. I didn't want to talk too much. It was 5 months. I went to the press conference, and they asked me to say something. I didn't have much to say. I said, we're just going to refight the last round, right? So when I done, we refought the last round. First time he quit and act like he was knocked out. But when he got touched with these bees, he started doing some dancing and falling and flipping around like a dead whale. Somebody been shot with a pistol. You feel me? That's Larry. That's how you look at a man hit you for real and you down. You don't do all this just flopping on his face. No. He ain't do that when he got hit for real. So that's how you know the difference. You feel me? That's how I know it's some foolery. but I ain't getting it. I'm good with it. I have a bad taste in my mouth because that was my first loss. And had I not lost that, I might have never lost. Because my goal was to not lose. I had just got robbed of a gold medal in Seoul, Korea. I'm still looking for him too. But, but then this, you understand me? Fred the Fat Boy break up, now this. You know what I'm saying? What the hell going on? But it bought something out of me that never would have been bought out of me had that not happened to me. Because a lot of people didn't know that I had the heart or that I was the killer that I really was. And I tried to leave that part of me at home. That's why I said I have two people. The one, I know you know, the one that can go out and perform and entertain you guys, that's what I love to do. That's what Muhammad Ali taught me. To be an entertainer, to make people feel like they didn't waste their time paying attention to Roy Jones Jr. in a boxing ring. You feel me? My goal was to, I'd rather die than have y'all come there and say y'all was bored watching Roy Jones Jr. perform, because this is valuable time. Tomorrow's not promised to nobody, right? So if y'all give me y'all time, I got to entertain y'all, right? So that they gonna referee me to my lair, I ain't never gonna forget him, because he almost got that lady child hurt. You understand me? I had bad intentions. I wasn't doing what all I wanted to do to the lady child. He just couldn't get up 4'10". If he'd got up 4'10", that might have been the end of him. You understand? Because I really had a lot of bad feelings in my heart tonight. But, you know, we're gonna let it go. We're gonna let bygone be bygone. I'm cool with that. God bless God. If I want God to forgive me, I got to forgive, right? So we all have to learn how to live and forgive one another. If we can't forgive one another, then how can we truly call ourselves brothers and sisters? And how can we expect for God to forgive us if we can't forgive our fellow brothers and sisters, right? Right? Along with all the other stuff going on, you know, it's like life is good. I never thought I'd see the day. I got into anybody's Hall of Fame because I really don't have no enemies, but for some reason my phone keep getting ringed to my somebody want to jump on me for what I don't know. I got bad knees, I got arthritis. I just don't get it. You know, I thought I was one of the nicest guys to ever grace the sport of boxing. Why are people still picking on me, I don't know. You know, Mike Tyson called, "What you want to fight me for? What I did to you? Why me?" Then he said, "Nah, we're gonna do it 2 times. No, we not. No, we not. No, we not. No, we not. 1 time, that's all you get, buddy. If you don't taste this here that time, you'll never taste this here. I can promise you that. If you don't taste that here that night right there, you will not taste this here. You hear me? You hear me? It will not happen. And I did have some hot sauce in the back, because if he'd have bit my ear, my hot sauce was coming out and I was gonna taste his ear too. You understand? You're not gonna bite Roy Jones. My mama don't play that. My mama said, they hit you, you hit them back. They bite you, you bite them back. You bite me, and you got a problem. You're gonna think you're in there with a rabid dog. Because I'm gonna bite you back, and I might not stop at one bite. That's why I bought the whole bottle of hot sauce. You understand me? So it is what it is. But anyway, man, I have had a great career. I've enjoyed entertaining you guys my whole life. Like I said, you meet angels, man, and to meet people like Vinny Pazienza, Ray McCline, Ed Mercer tonight. You know, those guys were two peas in a pod when I came along. And to see an event like this, where one reach out and grab the other and they both still come in and show up, is heart touching. Because those are true brothers. You feel me? That makes me more emotional than anything. Because I know Cole, and I know Ray, and I know how far back they go. And I know how much they've been through. And how hard they sacrificed and how much they gave of themselves to the sport. And to see them both come back here tonight, and Cole didn't come up by himself, he brought his buddy with him. That means a lot to me. That's what you love about this sport of boxing. You learn who real, what's real, and you learn people that will never leave your life. These dudes, my brothers from now on, they'll never leave my life. None of them in this.